What's up, guys and gals, and I have completely forgotten what I was working on Tropico 5, but you and I together today are gonna figure it out. As I recall, we were trying to do like a power plant or something. Something was going sincerely wrong with our overall power grid, and then we were also trying to bring ourselves into the future. So did this save us? Like, are we providing power now? Is there power occurring? This brownout thing is really kind of hurting me. It's making me sad, and I'm not completely sure how to fix it. Let's see here. Is it because we are out of coal? That's not producing because there's coal right there. I think it has something to do with our coal imports. Let's take a look. We're going to pause the game for a minute, and I'm willing to bet it has something to do with the fact that we have very little coal coming in. And I don't think there's any way to produce coal. I think you would actually need a coal mine in order for that to be solved. There's a uranium deposit, so we can bomb people into a... Oh, wow, we have a bunch of mining resources. Never mind, there is coal on the other side of our land right there. I don't know if it's going to be worth... I think we're going to continue importing it for right now, but we do have a bunch of ships. So let's go to our trade menu and let's see if we can't put an end to this whole thing. We're not going to export coal. We really need to import coal. And so I suppose we'll import coal from Venezuela for 2 months. I don't know how many more times we can sign that check right there, but we need it. We need it very, very badly. And so we'll put both ships on importing coal from Venezuela. But in the long term, I don't think that this is looking like a solution. And so what we want to do right now is we actually want to start clearing out to get to a location where, God, the coal mines are way on the back end of the island. This is not a good thing for us. The transit time alone, just moving dots and pixels around, gonna cause us some major problems. So until we can actually get our power consumption back up, or I'm sorry, our power production back up, I am thinking that this may not be a feasible plan. Now, what is this doing right here? That is the Isabella. And is it exporting or is it importing? I think it's exporting if it's on the left side. We have plenty of money. We have an opportunity to influence the outcome of- we're not gonna take election fraud right now. We don't really need to. We just need to get our imports back up and running. Like, something has gone very, very oddly right now. Okay, so that's exporting. Okay, and so the election results are in. We still get to be the Tropican Presidente, which is exactly a good thing because that's what we've been working towards this entire time. This place appears to have power. It looks like it's doing okay. What are you doing right here? You're importing coal, 3,000 of it. See that right there? That looks like a coal spot. That looks like a oil spot. And if we have oil right here off the edge, oh, we are going to be in very, very good shape, my friends. So I am hoping. Why is coal here as an output? I don't want to sell coal to anybody. I want all the coal for myself. I swear to God, if you export that coal right there, I'm going to murder you. Somebody is going to get assassinated if this coal does not end up at a power plant very, very shortly. Coal? Anybody? Anybody want to drop some coal into one of these buildings? I would 100% appreciate it. I would like you a lot better. Feeling kind of nervous about the future at the moment. Let's sign the treaty, and we're going to go into modern times, I think.
My fellow diplomats want us to ally with the Allies and to give the Axis the axe.
Okay, well, let's close that down for just a second. We can send an ambassador to the Axis.
Anxious Axis diplomat who said he will sign any piece of paper I want, just as long as you don't tell anyone what they were doing during the war.
Every treaty comes with a prescription to Ativan, just to keep him on the up and up. Okay, and the oil industry is now available. We've entered the Cold War period. Tourism is available. Research and construct nuclear space programs.
I have a wonderful new message for you. The times are a-changing, and it's Cold War time, people. Well, I don't know what that means, but it's always hot here on Tropico. So I guess we'll be fine.
So can I convert this into something else? It begins to consume natural gas instead of coal. It does look like we're producing electricity again, though, so I'm a little bit confused right now. Oh, never mind. We've collapsed one more time. Total power available. Available power, 1. So this one right now has coal, but this one doth not. So it looks as though our coal is being supplied sort of unevenly to differing locations. This might become a problem. Hopefully coal distribution kind of solves itself very, very shortly. So I guess the rebels are coming for our head. We told- oh my god, so apparently he made election posters that look too much like wanted posters and now people are after us. Great. Well, let's go ahead and see if maybe we can upgrade an oil refinery, sure. Let's go with oil refinery because it looks as though we have oil right there. And it looks as though we have oil- did I see one up here? We might only have one spot for an oil derrick. This may not work out that great for us. Okay, and so I'm thinking, let's take a look at our trade routes right now. We're importing as much coal as we can. If we could import it from another location, that would be great. So I'm gonna remove one ship from that export cycle. And we can import from, we've already got Venezuela coming in. We could take natural gas, but it's kind of expensive. So let's just import coal from China, which is going to make the U.S. upset, but they're not exporting. Why would that make the U.S. upset? They're not even exporting coal.
Hola, dear listeners.
Oh, my God.
I wanted to wish my boyfriend Raul and his comrades luck in their upcoming surprise attack against our totalitarian regime. My heart is with you, Raul.
What are the rebels attacking right now? They're blowing up our steel mill? That seems like kind of a dick move. You guys don't have cars or anything? I should probably invest in some source of mobility for my troops. We've got enough electricity coming from there. Why is no coal coming to here, though? I'm a bit confused how so much coal is landing over here, but so little coal is landing over here. Oh, there it is. They just got an import of coal. So we should be alright. We defeated the rebels, obviously, because I've got a death squad. How could I not defeat rebels with a death squad? We probably don't have enough teamsters or something. I don't know.
We discovered the mineral oil, which can be processed into gasoline. The cars in Tropico no longer need to run on magic. Our profits are guaranteed until someone starts selling oil cheaper than us. Then we should bomb and invade them.
Yeah! That's how we do business here. We only have one spot where oil is actually available, I think, and it seems to have vanished. It might have just been a shadow. So, we've got the oil refinery. I suppose we'll go with democracy for right now. I'm gonna slow the game down for a minute so that I can get a handle on what's been going on. And looking around Tropico, there are a number of things that we need to take care of. We can't sign a treaty until the USSR likes us.
Mr. President, I trust you saw the rabble protesting in the streets. They want you to show them the way out of this blind alley.
So they want us to make filthy rich people. 3 more of them, so we'll go ahead and do that, because that shouldn't be a problem at all.
Old boy, I just found myself in a very peculiar situation. I just met with a very embarrassed Soviet diplomat who needs our help.
It appears the USSR needs a place to stash parts that, I quote, have been nowhere near Cuba. Shall we help him out? Sure, why not? Let's build a couple military bases. We got the cash to do it. And we need it anyways, so we might as well get this underway before anything else terrible happens. We've got such a high vote in, like, command that it's just whatever. We should be able to do just about anything that we want. Oh, a customs office. I should probably do that too. The question is it custom built? Like, can you build the customs office to order? I guess would have been the more sly way of telling that joke, but nonetheless, we've made the joke, there it stands, and so we continue. Put it right there in front of the guard towers. Oh my, I don't think anybody's gonna be committing any import or smuggling fraud in front of that place. Can I upgrade anything here? Baccarat tables or slot machines. Over here, we can't do anything with that. Can we do anything? We have a farmer's fair right there. I'm interested in upgrading just about everything that I can, if it's available, now that we've entered a new era. We can do condition dryers, and we can also do machine choppers. Sure, let's go with machine choppers. That'll kind of speed the process up a little bit. Over here at our other factory, we can do electric sales. We can also do a supply market that's going to make it more effective. And then the supply market is going to make it Oh, I guess it makes the nightclubs, taverns, and so forth more successful. And it looks like we have some of those right over here, so we'll go ahead and do that because I'm testing things out. I'm trying new stuff. It also looks as though... Do I have the money to modernize all of my houses? Not quite. We're almost there. How's our coal supply looking? Is our coal supply holding steady, or are we diminishing back and forth? Looks like we're diminishing a little bit, so I think
the... We tried to discover democracy, but it proved extremely difficult. Building a true democracy is like chasing a unicorn. Everybody has heard of them, but no one has ever seen one. We captured a whole herd of unicorns, but not a glimpse of democracy anywhere to be found. However, we did discover the expectation of democracy, which should be more than enough for simple Tropicans.
This game is pretty barbed. The developers are really kind of throwing it out there. They're being very, very passive-aggressive. I mean, I admit that I like it a lot. As somebody who enjoys humor, I really do like the fact that they didn't walk away from making humor on this level. Oh, look, we have more options. So we can go with... Security survey. Okay, so we have personal rights. Under personal rights, we can go with total state control, which gives us reduced liberty, but assassination and banish actions are way cheaper. We can go with security surveillance, or we can have a open society. Let's go with an open society, because I think that, let's go with security surveillance. We'll keep a limited amount of surveillance going on, because I like controlling power and staying in power. Economy structure, it can be a plutocracy, we can do a planned economy. So basically we can do something that's essentially a little bit more like what you might see in North Korea, where everything is planned, everything is kind of set up from the ground up. Plutocracy, we can get all Swiss bank account gains up by 20%. Or we can increase the budget impact of our building effectiveness. This is a tough call because we do need to start padding our bank account as we go into the late game. So I'm going to go with plutocracy. The other one is very, very good because we're running a society... Well, let's go with free market. I can pad myself other ways. And believe me, I've been padding off camera, obviously, because YouTube has very strict community guidelines. But we've been padding. Media independence. So we can have total propaganda, which means you give less liberty, but protests happen less frequently. Subsidized media. Media requires a higher budget. Journalists convert voters for your cause. Or independent media, which makes their... I'm going to go with subsidized media. I don't need more protests. People run around the street with terribly made signs with horrible puns. No, thank you. We'll go with an airport next. Actually, we'll go with a supermarket. Then we'll go with the airport because we need to start getting... I need to decide on an end of the island that's going to be for tourism. I'm thinking it's going to be this little slice over here before you get to the coal mine. So basically this area and maybe certain aspects of that area too. It seems like we go through feasts and famine. We're going to upgrade these slightly to make the jobs a bit better, but we're not going to do the gas turbines yet because we can't afford it. Our imports should be coming in. Our exports are keeping us afloat quite well, and I don't mean to be punny about that considering they're all coming in on boats. I kind of said that without thinking, but there it is. There is the pun. We haven't built anything in this episode, and so I'm thinking we probably should. I think the last thing that I was really thinking about was the possibility of increasing our educational standards. And so I'm going to put in roads right there. But the next round of construction... will more than likely be up and in here. So let's go ahead and we'll start making some of this land a bit ready for us. And in so doing, we can sort of guarantee a bit more of our future. So we'll just have a bunch of long roads up here. And we'll start plopping down the things that we need in order to make this another metropolitan center. This is looking good, and I like to plan things out a little bit better than most people do. Just because I get nervous about things. So I want to be careful about my logging operation over here. Realistically, I could build down the beach over here. I'm going to let that logging operation expire before I go any further. On this side, what I would suggest is that we drop one more road down here. Although I've got to get it straightened out, which is going to be the difficult part. It might be easier to go from this direction and then go like so. and then just leave it unconnected, or maybe connect it through like a weird little road right here. Yeah, there it is. That's about as far as I could take it. So as far as this is concerned up here, we'll make this residential on both sides. I'm just going to start building purely houses, since we put in that edict that allows houses to be owned by poorer people. And so we'll just start off with houses over here. Seems like a pretty good plan. So there it is. We'll drop a road on this side. We'll do the exact same thing one more time. Oh, I misspaced that. Oh, well, we'll put in a park or something and that'll fix it, right? Eh, it's wabi-sabi. The imperfections will make things look better. How are we doing with unemployment? So we have a lot of people that aren't educated. That's okay. I think the best thing I could do right now would be to put in a Teamsters union over here to help out with some of this. So let's put in a Teamsters office on this side where people can work. And we'll continue. A building permit has earned us $620 this year. That is not nearly as lucrative as I was hoping it would be. We can level up for $50,000. I'm going to do that. So we've leveled up. Our global effect makes the production of buildings increase by 4 and effectiveness have increased. Okay, so we can be a foreman as well. We can also level up her and make her better at stuff. Considering we have so many mines, it might have been a better idea to have her level up a whole bunch. So maybe that's what we'll do. When do I get a new member of my family? Maybe I don't get a new member of my family. Oh well. Our cash appears to be dropping off slightly, so let me take a little bit of a break from production here, and we'll wait for all these buildings to get locked in. What edicts do I have available for the modern world? So let's go through these so that we can get a feel for them. We've got secret police, so they find rebels and faction leaders faster. We have Big Brother. We have to have secret police for that, though, so we can't even use most of those. We have waste sorting, which lowers the pollution from all residential buildings, so maybe I'll do that. A contraception ban, not worried about that. Geological survey, I'll probably do that one because it's expensive, but I think it'll be worth it for the long duration of our playthrough. Hydraulic fracking, we're not going to go for that right now. Sensitivity training, all military and police buildings reduce liberty costs. Okay, so I'll walk away from those for right now. Everything else looks okay, though. Pretty glad with where we're sitting. I do want to keep an eye on our cash, though, over the course of the next couple episodes, because we have been putting a lot of things into motion that could very distinctly lower our profits over the coming times. And so I just want to make sure that that doesn't happen. So yeah, we're out of coal right there. We really need new coal partners. Or the ability to supply our own. Where's my embassy at? Let's make friends with the USSR. We're gonna bring the USSR in. And they are now warm with us, but I think it said that we needed 80 to open up trade lanes with the USSR. And it was China that I needed coal from anyways. I can import logs. Uranium, okay. Oil, alright. We can export corn and meat to the USSR. Yeah, we need 80 standing. So unfortunately, we're going to have to do that twice. Which is a little bit weak. How much is that supplied to our slush fund? Like nothing? Okay, so we would need far more banks in order for that to be an effective strategy to pad our bank account. Slow the game down slightly. Are all these buildings done yet? 98% approval rating. We are killing it right now. We are straight killing it. Housing is very, very high at the moment. We have basically nobody that's homeless.
Presidente, we discovered the best thing since... probably the best thing ever.
So we've got the supermarket. Let's go ahead and plop one of those down up here and just see how it helps us out. I don't even know where that's going to be listed under. Not really interested in tourism or anything. We'll deal with that in a little bit. That's always a late game concern anyways. You don't tend to focus on tourism until way, way later. We can make a cathedral now. Oh, and we can make hospitals too. Interesting. I think it might be a worthwhile exchange to think about maybe bulldozing something over here so that we can put in a hospital. I might go for the destruction of... I don't know if it'll fit right there though. we have going on over here?
Isn't it wonderful that the two political blocks are trying to nuke each other out of existence?
We're not going to take that quest right there. Was for uranium exports. Not going to take that right now. Is this fort even useful to us anymore? Does it do anything? Because it's taking up a lot of space, and I'm thinking that if I make two more bases, I could just demolish this. Let's go ahead and demolish it. It employs a lot of people, but we're going to make military bases anyways, so who cares? We'll replace it with a modern military base. Or maybe a couple of barracks so that I can fit something else in here. The barracks is smaller, so we'll go with that. And then the other thing that I wanted to build was a hospital. And so since we've got the ability to make one. Is that the front of the hospital or the back? I can't tell. There's gardens and stuff on that side, so I'm thinking maybe that's the front. Let's go ahead and put in a hospital next to all of our residential areas, and that'll help us out making people happier over the course of the game. And then we could drop another barracks down here to replace the squads or whatever it is that we lost. This also affords us a little bit of extra construction space, so we'll go with research. Let's start off with executives, I guess. We'll take this, actually we'll go flight, I suppose. A cathedral? Oh, that's huge. Never mind. We're not going to be able to put that anywhere. A TV station, maybe? Ah. And there really is no bad space for us to put a TV station. So I think if we drop it right there, it'll be expensive, but we could play around with it and see what it does for us. Obviously, it probably increases liberty and does some other things if we want to use it that way. We could do a supermarket right here. We do want to be careful about our power consumption, though. Because brownouts are a very real and very unpredictable thing at the moment. I may convert this one to natural gas. And then what we'll do is we'll take somebody off the trade route. Since we do have an extra ship. We can get natural gas from them. Let's add a ship there. And then we'll also try and do an export that'll make up for the money. So we will export pineapples to the U.S. And so we're exporting pineapples, we're importing coal, and
Tropical spy, Mr. Presidente. We have a crisis, and we have to act fast.
Okay, so we have more rebels. I guess that's just one of those new things that we have to learn to deal with. We've got plenty of random stuff around. But I don't think it would hurt us to maybe shore up our security by dropping a final military base off to the side over here. There was a loud noise and I don't know what it was from. It came from the wall. I think somebody just fell off a shelf in a wall. Or in a closet, and unfortunately I can't look right now because we're mid-episode, so we've got a base over there. I'm trying to put the bases around randomly so that wherever they tend to pop in, we can fight with them. Let me upgrade the job security of this base, or the effectiveness of this base. Special forces training is going to be in modern times. Over here at the hospital, we'll do a hospitalization wing and an obstetrics wing. Max out the budget right there to make people filthy rich, which will allow us to complete the... Oh, we already completed the quest. Never mind. They want two military bases. I'm not really sure that I want to do that right now.
A new TV station has been built. Why all the fuss, people? If you want pictures with your news that badly, just lay back, listen to me, and picture me drinking a glass of milk as some of it runs down my chin from my big, soft lips.
Oh. Damn, girl. You had to give it away that easy. I mean...
So furious. I cannot believe what just happened.
So we're under attack by rebels. That'll probably be the last thing that happens during this episode, but we did put down military bases just in case. They're attacking my iron mine? That's not a very kind thing to do. So I suppose I'll put a barracks out here somewhere, or at least some guard towers. It looks like we're winning a battle against nobody. Oh, there they are.
When do we charge?
They're making their way slowly off in that direction. I don't know if they'll win or not, but it'll be a distraction. Got another military unit coming from there. Getting rid of that massive fort, I think, really just kind of... They overpowered our defenses? Well, that's because we have nothing. Okay, so let's build a military base up here. Or at the minimum. We have to build two for the quest anyways. So let's just get it underway. We'll put an army base up here. and that'll provide extra work because we are going off conscription, and so that'll provide extra work for our lower class citizens, after which point...
Presidente, we discovered flight! It's just like falling, but backwards. I can't believe no one thought of it before. Then we discovered landing. It's just like splatting, but it hurts.
Splatting. All right, well, I'm going to break the episode off right here. My name is Splattercat. Thank you for joining me in the Nerdcastle for another episode of Tropico 5. I look forward to seeing you all in the coming episodes. Take care out there, everybody, and haidu.